Despite terror threats issued by the United Kingdom and the U.S. mission in Kampala warning their citizens against attending the Nyege Nyege festivities in Jinja, the police have revealed that the four-day entertainment event was a major success, with only a few minor cases reported. Addressing the media during the weekly security briefing, the police spokesperson Fred Enanga noted that 20 mobile phones and one car were stolen during the event.
Combating terrorism remains a top priority for the joint security agencies and the government of Uganda. We therefore remain committed to bringing to justice all perpetrators of violence who harm our citizens.
With over 300 security personnel deployed to secure the event, a few cases of forgery, drug abuse, impersonation and petty thefts were reported during the 4 days. Meanwhile, police have urged members of the public to be vigilant ahead of the festive season.
So I want to warn those treasurers who are keeping village savings that they really need to be very, very vigilant during this period. Because in Maga Maga Town Council, like I was explaining, these armed thugs attacked and robbed Wamunga Daniel, a 46-year-old LC1 chairman of Church Zone, around 7:30 p.m.
Also, one Farida Nabakoza, a bus conductor, is in police custody for allegedly trafficking a Congolese refugee from Nachivale refugee camp to DR Congo. The suspect, who is a minor, is said to have been recruited in tourist activities after Nabakoza secured them travel to Congo.
The public tends to be complacent in a number of cases when we have guidance. They tend to assume that someone else will report on their behalf if somebody is being victimized or if there are threats available.
From the Uganda National Examination Board, the UNEB spokesperson Jennifer Kale has cautioned students, teachers and parents against any forms of exam malpractice.
Once you are caught, it is an offense. So we want to caution you against involvement in that kind of practice. Finally, we want to thank members of the public who have been very vigilant and very supportive. Most of these cases, we always pick wind of them when members of the public do give us whistleblowers' reports, and that enables us to follow it up, and eventually it leads us to the scene of crime in good time.
Over 100,569 students registered for the examinations at the level of Uganda Advanced Certificate of Education in 2,103 centers. 43% are female and 57% are male, which is 11.4% increment from the 97,889 students who registered last year. This year, 34 candidates are inmates at Luzira Upper Prison. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.